Welcome to another episode of the Climbing Diaries. This time I'm here again to do a deep analysis of my last competition, the World Cup, lead World Cup in Innsbruck. It was my first competition since 2019. My last one was in Japan in October 2019, when I finished third. So my last experience in a World Cup was quite positive. So this was my first World Cup of the year, first World Cup in 2 years. In the qualification, I climbed well and managed to pass to the semi-final in fourth position. And we were 102 competitors, and the first 26 advanced to the semi-final. After the qualification, the next day there was the semi-final, that is an on-site route, just one route, and from 26 the first 8 advanced to the final. So I started with the observation of the semi-final, and I immediately noticed that the route was weird and quite hard. There were a lot of crimps, but a lot of volumes and slopers too. And I think it was not totally my style, because I couldn't find any rest. Anyway, I climbed not at my best. I was a bit nervous, because it is a hard round, the semi-final, because you decide if you are going to the final or if you are stopped there. And I climbed not at my best. I did some mistake, but I could rest a bit on some crimps. And then I was quite lucky to finish in 8th position of the semi-final. And thanks to my previous round, thanks to the qualification, I was quite high in the ranking. So I was tied with other competitors, and I advanced to the final thanks to the qualification round. The semi-final was held in the morning, and that evening there was the final. And from 101 or 2 competitors in the previous day to 26, and in the final we were just 8. The final, again, it is a on-site route, so we are not allowed to watch other competitors climb. We are just allowed to watch together for 6 minutes the route, and try to find the beta, try to imagine what will we climb later. And that's one of the best moments in climbing, because even if you are 8 competitors, one against each other, we try to share our beta, we try to share information that we can understand from the ground. Is it not always possible to understand everything from the ground, but we maybe 90% of the beta we can figure out when we are watching from the ground. Is it possible even to use a binocular to watch better some small holes that sometimes are not possible to see them from the ground? And the best thing for climbing is that in that moment we are all friends that share better together, because it is like the competition is not against each other, but is from our side against the route. So we have a common enemy, that is the monster route set by the route setter, that try to make us a challenge and try to set some tricky moves, maybe, that sometimes are hard, sometimes are easy to understand. In this case, the final was, I think, quite understandable. Not easy to climb, but there were not a lot of tricky moves, as in the final round for the women, for example, that was a lot more tricky with the jumps and mantles. It was quite weird. While our final was more classical style, the first section was with some slopers, but they were quite good, blue slopers with double texture, which is a bit hard at the beginning to trust. And then the second section, there were some small crimps, which I feel very good on them. And then the next section, there were some banana slopers, like green long pinches. And then the final section, again, there were a lot of crimps, which is again my style. So when I watched the route, I immediately thought this could be my route, could be my style. And I started climbing, I had no pressure because I was 8th in the ranking, so I started climbing first. And this helped me a bit with my mind because I had no pressure, no expectation. I was already last in the finals, so everything I would do, it would be a victory for me because I already had a hard time to go through the final. And even if I finish in the 8th position, would be a victory for me. The moment when I feel the most pressure is when I'm starting on the before going out to the stage. I can see the crowd. There were not a lot of people, obviously, but usually I can feel a high pressure there because if I'm not starting first, the other climber, the climber before me, in that moment is climbing. So I can feel the crowd, I can feel him screaming maybe, and somehow I can understand how high he gets. Not the specific hold he gets, but from the crowd, from the public, I can understand if the climber before me went high or fell really low. In this case, I was the first out, so I had no pressure, no expectation, and the small crowd that was in Innsbruck had no expectation too. So everybody, I think, cheer me on and try to push me, going higher and higher. So I started really not nervous. I climbed the first section quite well. I even trust a foot on a Polish hold, on a double texture hold, and I climbed well until a good rest that helped me to recover. Usually my style is pure endurance, and when I find a good rest I can recover really well. So I arrived to this last blue hold and I rested and tried to clear my mind and prepare myself for the next section. The next section was quite crimpy with some wooden volumes, and I climbed again quite well without doing any mistakes. And I found another rest on the last volume on the overhanging. Then I climbed again quite well, I think, in the green banana section with some heel hooks and quite technical moves that usually are not my style, but this time maybe without the pressure, and I risk a bit with some really high heel, and somehow I managed to pass the crux of the route. It was really hard, but for me it didn't feel so hard because I wasn't pumped and I was focused on my climbing. When I did this move going to the vertical crimp, where a lot of climbers later fell, I felt that it was hard, and in my mind I thought that maybe someone could fall there because it was a bit harder than the previous moves. But then I climbed through the next session and I found myself in the last holds. There was this black undercrimp volumes. The next hold was a yellow crimp that was the next hold and the one before the top. I understood that the right beta would be going to the crimp with the left hand, then switch my foot on the big volume on the right, and then going to the top with the right hand. But I was a bit pumped and I thought that it was hard to go with the left hand to the crimp. So I thought, if I go with the left hand and I fell and I fall, my points in the final ranking would be using this hold going to the crimp, but if I go with the right hand I can easily take it and control it, that is a higher point, and then from there maybe I can go to the top. So I thought, okay, I'm going with the right hand, and then I switched my foot to the right volume, and then it was not possible to move from that position. So my last and final score was this hold controlled. When I fell, I thought, okay, this is a good result anyway, even if I didn't top the route, it was very close. I was the first climber out, so Maybe everybody thought this route is too easy, because if the last one can go so high, maybe the other ones that in the semi-final were even higher can easily top this route. But I know this was my style, and I knew that I did a good competition, but I didn't know what to expect, if it was enough for a podium or if the other climbers just could walk the route and everybody can top and I could still finish in 8th position. But then the other climbers start to fall before me. Almost everybody in the crux that I understood was hard. And even Alex Mego said his style is very crimpy and endurance, fell at that move. And then the only climber that was able to pass the cracks was Jakob Schubert, that reached the same hold that reached with the right hand without the same thing. And he tried to go to the top doing a plus, and this was enough for him to win the competition. And I was at the end second, but even if I was so close to the victory, I was very happy, because it was my first competition after a long time, and being second, but more important, being able to climb that well without pressure in a World Cup final was for me the highest satisfaction, because I was maybe not sure if I was able to climb that well after my semi-final that was not of one of my best performance. So at the end, when Alex fell, we watched again together the route, and we watched the other competitors, and we discussed about the beta, but then it was too late for us to try the route again. And the podium was Jakob Schubert first, me second, and the third was Sascha Lehmann, who fell at the crux of the route, but maybe it took one hold higher than the other, so he was third. I'm really sorry for Adam Ondra, that fell early on the route because of a foot slip. It would be very interesting to see him climbing the crack section, and I was curious to see him on the very top and if he could top the route, but competition are competition. You have just one try for each route, and even a small mistake can end the competition sooner than expected. Thanks for watching my analysis, and see you in the next competition and in the next climbing diaries.